Hey guys, what is going on? Today we're going to be finishing up the engine.
We got everything for the head right here. We have Tome valve springs, Tome cams. On my exhaust manifold, I got new studs. Previous owner of this snapped that off, so I have to get that out, but I do have another stud for that. As you can see, I got the rest of the cylinders and head studs in there. If we go in here, we have all of the gaskets. We have a Tome head gasket, just a bunch of other gaskets. Right here we have pulleys, which I'll go over later. And right here we have Brian Crower titanium valve retainers. And yeah. So the first thing that we're going to do is get all of the valve retainers and springs out. We already got one out because we don't have the right tool, so we just wanted to make sure that this method would work, and it does, because otherwise I was really worried because it's like $50 for the right tool, and then that would have taken a long time to come. So I stopped filming because we couldn't get these two out. It's now 2 hours later and we were finally able to get them out. And then as far as putting them back in, we got this one back in just to test to see if the way we were gonna do it is gonna work. So this is gonna suck a lot, but I'm pretty confident that this will work. Here are the Tome valve springs and the BC titanium retainers. I forgot to show those. So my camera died while I was filming that time lapse, and then I used my phone, and then that ran out of memory, so I had to delete some stuff, and then I finished that time lapse with my phone. But everything is all back together. We have the new valve springs and retainers in. I just set the cams back in. Yeah, the next thing that we're going to be doing is putting on the head gasket. And here I have a Tome. I don't know if you can see it, but I got a 1.2 millimeter. I'll go over a little bit more like what my setup is going to be when I talk about the turbo, but running a little bit lower boost so I can make a little more power, easier to tune. So I'll give this one a shot. I also have some copper spray that I'm going to be using. I'm not going to be breaking the whole head gasket apart. I'm just going to be spraying the top and the bottom because it's Tome and this is how they make it. So I'm sure it works good already, but I am going to still spray the top and the bottom, and then we'll get the head on. So, I don't have the right socket, so this is probably going to be the end of me filming for today. It's kind of getting dark, and my lens is a piece, and it does not film well in low light, so I'm moving. So I will pick this video up again tomorrow. So I got the timing all done, and something I didn't talk about before was I got these OBX pulleys, and then there's another one in here. This isn't the color that they're going to stay. I'm going to get them painted or something, I think, to match my valve cover. But yeah, these are the only pulleys that they make that are aftermarket for the KA. So got to have a little bit of eBay on this. So the engine's pretty much back together. We got the cams in, oiled them up, got the front timing cover on, the oil pump on, we got the new billet OBX pulleys, harmonic balancers on, alternators on, thermostats in there, and then we also got the alternator on. I don't really like how bad this looks, not the plastic, but like the metal. So I might take it apart and paint it, but I'm probably gonna try Scotch-Briting it first. And then right here, I think these are stainless manifold studs and nuts. I didn't say that I got those before. So I also got those. Engine mounts are on, and then I guess we'll get into this. So it's always a good day when you get one of these boxes. So here's my turbo. This is a Garrett GT2871R, 56 trim, 86 AR. The reason why I went with that is because I don't really want to come up short on my power goals.
So I'm building like my whole setup to sacrifice a little bit of spool for the potential to make more power.
Like with my head gasket, I got a 1.2 millimeter, so I can be running a little bit less compression, which will make it easier to tune and it'll make more power, but it won't spool as fast. And then I also got the bigger housing. Now, I already clocked this and everything, so I guess we'll toss this on and I'll talk a little bit more about that. We're not going to be mounting it up permanently because I tried drilling this out, and I'm just going to have to pay $50 to have a machine shop do it, so that really sucks. So it's just going to be kind of a mock-up so you can
see what it looks like.
Here's it with the valve cover on and the turbo and turbo manifold on. This is how I had to clock it, and I had to flip the bracket around, otherwise it was going to be like up here. And then to do that, I had to cut part of the rod on the actuator, and then I just got this long nut and then another screw, and then I just cut the head off and it's in between there, and it's really good. There's no wobble, and I'm pretty sure that's how it's gonna be clocked, or how I need to have that for my intercooler piping. So the reason why I went with an internal wastegate is because I want my exhaust to be really spooly and make a lot of turbo sounds, and when you go with an external wastegate,
it makes your exhaust sound NA, and then you just have like the turbo sound coming out of the screamer, like with Adam LZ's external gate on his SR and Alberto's external gate on his engine. And I just don't really like how that sounds, but like it sounds good on like RBs and JZs, but I figured I might as well try it this way. If I don't like it, I can always just get a new exhaust housing that has a V band to mount an external gate to, or they make like a screamer elbow, and that's another thing that I like about going with the T2 and like keeping with like a lot of SR stuff, is I could get like the elbow, and then because it's meant for a T2 turbo, the seal will be really good. But I'm gonna give it a try first without that, and then just have a, like dumping back into the exhaust. So there it is. This is the turbo that comes on the S15, essentially. Now, with the valve cover, I'm going to be doing something with that. I'm going to be getting this powder coated next week along with my pulleys. I already have a color picked out. I just have to strip it off camera. But yeah, just how it's looking. Also, finally took the time to get the body harness and the engine harness out. I don't really have time now to do it. The way my job works, my schedule flips opposite ends of the week, so I had 7 days off. So I really just tried to take advantage of all that time off and try to get as much progress done on the KA and the 240 as I could. And I'm pretty happy with what I got done. Really, all I have to do is just get the booster and the clutch master out, and then get the hard lines out, and then really just gotta get the battery tray out, and then start scuffing it up and getting that ready for paint, because I mean the engine's pretty much done, so it's really just mainly on the bay. So tomorrow I'm gonna be ordering my oil pan. Really expensive, it's gonna be like $600, because I want to have a trap door, so excessive makes like an oil pan, but then it has like a piece that you can put an SR oil pan on, so then I'm also going to get the ISR SR oil pan to put to the bottom of it, and that has like the baffling and stuff to hold the oil. And then if we come over here,
Still haven't done anything with the intake manifolds. I got to strip these all the way down because I'm going to get these powder coated this week, hopefully. Or maybe I'll do it later. I don't know. I also would like a new fuel rail. And I'm going to need a fuel pressure regulator. I'm going to be using the stock injectors for my base map, just because that's one less thing to go wrong, and it doesn't really matter because it's just a base map. Give you a nice good look at the cams. When I put a breaker bar on the crank and I crank it over, everything is spinning really smoothly. Valves are opening nicely. Already got oil all over the cams, as you can see, so there's not going to be any scoring. The engine is pretty much done. Not done, but back together. Everything's torqued down. The cams are torqued down. There's just a few things I'm going to be ordering over the next couple weeks. Just button this up, and then after that, we really just got to work on the car itself and just start prepping the bay so we can get the engine back in there, and then we'll start with this. We'll start on the suspension and then all of the fun stuff, which will be all the visual stuff. And I can't wait to get these on. And I really just miss driving the car, and it's going to be a lot of fun with boost. So yeah, I think that's everything for this video. Engine's back together. If you're excited, subscribe for more. Drop a like if you like my videos. It's much appreciated. And I think that's going to be it. So I will see you in the next one.